In the Eucharist, we in fact encounter the living Jesus and his strength, and through him we enter into communion with our brothers and sisters in the faith, those who live with us here on earth and those who have gone before us into the next life, the unending life. In the great assembly of saints, God wanted to reserve the first place for the Mother of Jesus. Mary is at the centre of the communion of saints, as the singular custodian of the bond between the universal church and Christ, of the bond of the family. She is mother, she is our mother, our mother. For those who want to follow Jesus on the path of the gospel, she is a trusted guide because she is the first disciple. She is an attentive and caring mother to whom we can entrust every desire and difficulty. On the third day there was a wedding in Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does your concern affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servers, "Do whatever he tells you." Virgin, most holy and immaculate, to you, the honour of our people and the loving protector of our city, do we turn with loving trust. You are all beautiful, O Mary. In you there is no sin. Awaken in all of us a renewed desire for holiness. May the splendour of truth shine forth in our words, the song of charity resound in our works. Purity and chastity abide in our hearts and bodies, and the full beauty of the gospel be evident in our lives. Amen. There are 2 points to consider today, the first of which has to do with Mary as the centre of the communion of saints. Ask yourself, how often do I pray through Mary as an intercessor to my Lord and Saviour Jesus? We can pray through many saints to intercede on our behalf with the Lord, but there is none so close to him as his mother, who interceded on behalf of a newly married couple asking Jesus to perform the first miracle of his public ministry. Secondly, as we read above, the Holy Father comments on the wondrous union that takes place between heaven and earth during the Eucharist. The next time you're at Mass, focus intently on the words of the Eucharistic prayer. Listen carefully to each word and reflect on the simple beauty and profound mystery of what is being spoken by the priest during this wondrous prayer. Reflect upon the reality of how heaven and earth come together throughout the structure of this wonderful prayer.
Thank you. More.